Do you want to move it, move it, move it? Are you ready to shake it, shake it, shake it? Well, then Samba Funk is the place for you. I'm actually going to join King Theo, Theo Williams, the founder of Samba Funk, who's bringing the African diaspora culture in music, art, and dancing to Oakland, the Bay Area, and the world. Today, I'm going to be Samba Funkin' in the Samba Funk's class held at the Malanga Center in downtown Oakland. People from around the world and the Bay Area come and have music and fun in this Samba Funkin' class. So join us as we Samba Funk today on Spotlight with Shonda Scott. Spotlight with Shonda Scott. We are here at Samba Funk. We're here, what was that, five, six years ago?
We first got it started, maybe about eight now.
This
may
be
going on
eight. Oh, wow. To get the story and behind the scenes on Samba Funk, who's now not just doing dance classes, but they're doing advocacy in the community. I mean, you're all over the world teaching classes. So just tell us about what inspired you, King Theo. I know you as Theo.
Right on. Tita. That's right.
Inspired you to do Samba Funk, and what's relevance in our community now?
Well, actually, my inspiration came from Ruth Jamerson in Mosswood Park. Going to Mosswood Park and just having access to dance classes and music and art and culture, that seed was planted inside me, and it just took a long time to germinate. We've been knowing each other. I've always been interested in entertainment, but not from an artist perspective.
Right.
I never was trying to be an artist. But in this particular space where we are here at the Malanga Center, it used to be called the Alice Arts Center.
Right.
Right downtown, owned by the
city. I think I took classes here when I was little.
Exactly.
Yeah, African dance classes.
That's right.
Yeah.
And the Oakland Ballet was here when it was active, and you know, now they're doing the Nutcracker. But in any case, in the studio we're in, which is one of the best studios in the Bay Area. Look at the lighting and the floor and the backdrop. When I moved back from Atlanta, I started African dance, or African Brazilian dance right here. And my teacher, his name was Carlos Acetuno. He lived around the lake. Carlos was a legend. My teacher.
Wow.
That's my teacher.
He did the carnival and
exactly.
all that in San Francisco.
Carijama,
when
it was in West Oakland. Now it's Oakland Carnival. And his teacher, Jose Lorenzo, we come from that whole seed, that lineage. He was the founder of the first samba school in the country, right here in the Bay Area, called Batucaje.
Right, I remember Batucaje.
Yeah, it was original.
So you're a spawn from
You
that
know what
world,
I mean?
Right?
You know what I mean?
But now you're not even, I mean, there was a point you're doing music around the lake and there was an issue, and then you got thrust into this advocacy too now. So how is Samba Funk, what's the advocacy behind Samba Funk? Is like keeping the culture in the community, or what is the advocacy component of it?
Well, part of it is that, you know, a lot of our cities, national cities, are facing gentrification, and the demographics of these cities are changing, the increase in the rents and everything, and with those changes you have new neighbors, and people wanted different things in their neighborhood, and sometimes they don't want drumming, outdoor live drumming. So
and that's what makes this area special, that you can get the culture outside.
Exactly, especially at the lake.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, with our particular incident that you're talking about, if the viewers may or may not be aware of it, but it kind of galvanized, and it led up to, there were various complaints about what was happening at the lake and who was having access to resources and having access to space. And when some resident from 1200 Lakeshore came down and tried to take my drumsticks out of my hand and complained that it was just too loud and too much, and then OPD came with 16 or 12 police cars, and it just became a big ordeal. It got picked up in the media, and it just became like the lightning rod to say that we have to stop the catering to the gentrifiers, and also remember that you have natives here like you and I, K-12,
right.
Went to college, came back here and giving back into the community.
And that culture is just so what makes this area special. So just remembering that we, although there's changes and people coming in that haven't been natives here, we still have pieces of the community that you want to keep.
Right.
And Samba Funk is like one of those essence. Some of us have took
classes, African dance classes, as a child. So now we're here raising our kids, and we want to have that option as well.
That's right.
And then we also want you to be connected in the community to help the city officials and the city realize the importance of keeping, preserving Samba Funk, Batuka J, all these, you know, cultural aspects.
Cultural equity is what we're looking for, and you know how it is. A lot of times folks have always talked about the cultural aspects of Oakland, but then it's been a lot of lip service. It really hasn't been a lot of financial support, and it hasn't been anything really tangible. So we've been working, like you speak to the advocacy, we've been working over the last couple of years to make the support tangible and not, you know, more than lip service.
Right. Well, I'm going to do more than lip service today, too, because I'm participating in the class.
Yeah, that's
so
right.
So last time you were on the show, you taught me how to drum.
Yeah.
And I would feel like I was like Sheila E. This time I'm going to take a little bit of class. It's been some years since I've taken my African dance, but I'm ready to participate.
Well, look,
so
I want to
tell me a little bit about the class, what I can expect.
Well, you can expect to have some fun. You know, we meet everybody at their level. That's what we like to say. Just we meet you wherever you are. And that we take what we do in the dance studio out into the community. So, you know, you may see us around the lake, but you may also see us in Sobrani. You know, because we're going to meet you where you are. That's what we do. We represent the town. We get down, black and brown. Right. Don't mess around. But you got to pay your $13. Not you. That's not a fee for you. You know, because, you know, superstars, when you get your own TV show, you too will be able to get free dance classes. I do African, Brazilian, and funk. So we're a fusion. I like to bring what I know, which is a whole college experience.
The whole stomp.
You know what I'm saying? That's right.
Greek.
Yeah, exactly. You know, bring that in, bring that flavor, and bring, you know, the South, what I learned when I was in Atlanta, and then also always border or base it on Africa and then border out to the African diaspora. So, it's live drums.
You've been to Brazil, too. So you've been to Brazil, and you've been teaching it all throughout the United States. What are you doing around the world?
Well, you know how it is.
Say,
folks in the OAL, we all over the place.
Right.
You know, people love Oakland. They love how we get down. We invented a new word called swag, and now everybody uses it.
Right.
So I meet different dancers and drummers, and we invite them. We do international cultural exchanges, and then they invite me as well. Mm-hmm. So I've been to Paris, I've been to Canada, to Toronto, like you said, Brazil, also West Africa, you know, teaching. And one beautiful thing is that Brazilian culture is a fusion culture as well. So I'm not Brazilian, I'm from Oakland, but I respect the culture, and I teach everything that I know.
Right. You're watching Spotlight with Shonda Scott, and we will be right back.
Every child needs a mentor, a positive role model. For me, that was my grandmother. For more than 110 years, Big Brothers Big Sisters has been making meaningful monitored matches between adult volunteers and children. And these positive relationships have direct and measurable impacts. Help a child realize his or her potential. Visit BigBrothersBigSisters.org.
Welcome to Spotlight with Shonda Scott, where each week we bring you the best and the brightest, the movers and the shakers, and the hidden gems from all over the Bay. Let us shine a spotlight on your business. Sponsorship opportunities are available. For more information, visit us at spotlightwithshonda.tv.
Yo, it's your man Tony Sko from the KBLX Dream Team, and you're rolling with the Spotlight with Shonda Scott. She's incredible.
Did you hear about the pony with a sore throat? He was a little horse.
Can I tell you a cat joke? Just kidding.
Why was the basketball court all wet?
Why?
Because the players kept dribbling all over it.
Where do cats go on vacation?
New York.
Stay tuned for more Spotlight with Shonda Scott. And follow us on our website at spotlightwithshonda.tv.
So they say it's a man's world? I don't see anybody's name on it.
While they were doing their thing, we slowly changed all.
Today, women can do anything men can do. And there's one thing we're even better at.
Stay linked in with us as you follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And remember, hashtag Spotlight with Shonda.
I wanted to actually start on a choreography that I started on last week. I may not get on that, but I want to go on. Oh, I see some new faces, so let's go over some samba basics. Come up a little bit, please. So samba, most of you all know, samba is an African-Brazilian dance. It was, I don't know if you can say invented, but it was introduced in Salvador, Bahia for the first 100 years of Brazil's existence. Salvador was the capital. And that's where the Portuguese landed, and that's where they set up shop, and that's where they were for the longest. And then they moved it to, I think, Rio and Brasilia and some other places. But this particular dance that you know or have seen probably has been popularized by what you think of when you think of Rio Carnival and the big costumes and the feathers and everything. But it actually started out as just an interaction between African and slave folks in Salvador, and it moved to Rio, and that's why we call it Rio style, as opposed to Samba Jehoda, which was the more earthy and country style. So I'm gonna show you a couple different techniques today. So first, samba is taught in triplets. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3. So I have a different technique that I like to teach. It's a bouncy technique if you haven't never done it before, but don't get too caught up in trying to bounce because you don't want to do that, but it's just a technique. So what we're going to do is go from side to side, and we're going to jump, we're going to hop, and we're going to hop in 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. So it looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, pivot turn. 1, 2, samba right here, go. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, samba to the right. 1, 2, 5, 6, 9 to the left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, back samba, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Samba Jehoda. Backslide. 4, 5, 8 more. 8 and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Walk it out, big 8. And 1. Pivot turn. Samba right here. Go. And 1. Samba to the right. 8. Hey, hey! Samba Jehoda forward! Hey!
Welcome to Spotlight with Shonda Scott, where each week we bring you the best and the brightest, the movers and the shakers, and the hidden gems from all over the Bay. Let us shine a spotlight on your business. Sponsorship opportunities are available. For more information, visit us at spotlightwithshonda.tv. You are watching Spotlight with Shonda Scott. If you missed an episode or want to see exclusive behind-the-scenes footage, go to our YouTube channel and join by clicking the subscribe button.
When I was six, my days were spent playing basketball. When I was six, my dream was to make it to the NBA. When I was six, my mom had a stroke.
I'm Paul George, and I want you to spot a stroke fast.
F, face drooping. A, arm weakness. S, speech difficulty. T, time to call 911.
Protect the ones you love.
Spot a stroke fast.
Hey, what's up? It's Antoine Davis, and you're on Spotlight with Shonda Scott. Stay tuned in. She'll have more to come.
One in six seniors faces the threat of hunger, and millions more live in isolation.
America, let's do lunch.
Drop off a hot meal and say a quick hello. Volunteer for Meals on Wheels by donating your lunch break at americaletsdolunch.org.
Testing. Why did the girl ask the mushroom to dance? Because he was a fun guy.
Stay linked in with us as you follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And remember, hashtag Spotlight with Shonda. We're here at Mindseed Compound.
Yes.
This is where you have everything happening now.
This is the new setting. Yes, it is. All through here, you know. The history of it, I told you a little bit about it.
A little bit about the Mindseed.
The history of the gentleman that did the music to Ms. Pac-Man in the late 70s. And this was his fortress. And
So there's a lot of genius in here.
Yeah, it's a lot of spirits in here, great ones. The energy is incredible. But I mean, but bouncing from, you know, I've always had locations in, you know, Oakland, where you really could be part of the real community. Mm-hmm. And people from here, and just give an opportunity. Starting off at 80th and Olive Street, and then West Oakland, where I had the House of Music, where I produced the Destiny Child, Indy Irie, and Keisha Cole lived pretty much in there. And you know, from there was the Pop Life and other things. And moving on, right now, man, what we've been doing here is like really fusing music and tech. Mm-hmm. You know,
that's powerful.
Tony School of Music. And we started that like 2 years ago.
Okay.
It's a 6-week program, and basically, you know, 20 kids to get the opportunity to be part of a production. Mm-hmm. You know, start out a project. I bring in the instructors that teach theory, vocals, script writing, storyboard writing. And then besides that, lightweight engineering and how to come in, just like walk into a venue and set it up.
So those people behind the scenes actually have a place, and the people who are in front all can learn that here.
And that's incredible. You fuse with the hidden geniuses.
Oh, okay, with the tech. That's time to check in.
They came here and to introduction to coding. Myself, I'm like a student, really, just to see this.
Because a lot of the music's on the computer now, right?
A lot of the music is, you know, it's streaming. It's ridiculous right now, all these different formats. And I'm so honored to be able to keep up with it because, you know, like I said, I really learned from the youth.
I'm from Oakland, you're from Oakland. Yes. It's like some things are, you know, take us back to our childhood.
Mm-hmm. So when I drive these streets, you know, I think about some of the places where, like a Royal Park, where they used to have African Liberation Day every year.
We
lived across the street from right across the street from there, we used to see the band set up early in the morning. Me and my brother, we'd be looking out the window and seeing the stages come up and all that. So that's really just what I've seen. Mm-hmm. And seeing Santana play in the park, seeing Larry Graham come to your school and play in the courtyard. Right. You know, so that's why I do that with other groups, because I understand
that. Now you're that artist young people, right?
Yeah, and I know that that's so much opportunity for them to see that and see how it all works. So you don't just fall for what you see on these, you know, these television shows of making or whatever else. The reality of this is the work behind it, but you should enjoy it.
Okay.
We are going to bring something incredible to Oakland.
Oh, so you're down in LA now? Oh, okay. That's why I don't see you all the time, except for on the road. Okay, which Tony are you? Which Tony are you? Which Tony? What's your Tony name?
The E.
You're the E?
Mm-hmm.
The silent E, no.
And then yours is the?
I'm the I.
30 years?
Coming up.
Yeah, coming up. That's what he came back to Oakland to talk about.
Oh, that's what I was going to say. We got to talk about 30 years. Come on now. You guys got to give us something. Yeah. 30 years.
Yeah.
Well, we've been laying out.
We've been following that long. You know, yeah.
We got a lot of concepts. We got a lot to say, though, now.
Right.
Because we experienced quite a bit, and it's quite a bit going on.
You know what I mean? Years.
Yeah.
Just in 30 years. Even before 30 years. Yeah.
I told her, I was like, I don't even
Especially those 30 years. Especially those 30 years. Because, like, the 80s, 90s, that was some good time, 30 years.
We went on bus tours. It's different.
Yeah. So you really had.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, no, we got a story.
Yeah. Our first tour was with Earth, Wind & Fire. And then from that, it was with NWA.
Wow. So that just that extreme.
Yeah.
But that's like the Tonys are that extreme. Like you could roll with NWA and Earth, Wind & Fire.
Then Salt & Pepper.
Right.
Hammer. You know, we toured with just about everything. Uh-huh. That's the album. That's our gold one from, which one was that? That's Tony, that's the Revival. Album.
The Revival, yeah.
It went double platinum.
Was this American Music Award?
Yep. That's, we got that in 91.
Wow.
What album was that? That was.
You just hold these like this, you know. Thank you very much.
Yeah, I was going to put it on the hood of my car.
You're watching Spotlight with Shonda Scott, and we will be right back.
Hart, what's going on?
I'm leaving.
Why? What did I do?
Not enough. You constantly ignore me. You barely eat anything healthy. You're half as active as you used to be. The pressure is just too much. I quit.
Okay, I get it. I'll do better. Just... please, don't leave.
Okay, but remember, if I go, you go.
Listen to your heart. Don't let it quit on you. Uncontrolled high blood pressure could lead to stroke, heart attack, or death. Get yours to a healthy range before it's too late.
Welcome to Spotlight with Shonda Scott, where each week we bring you the best and the brightest, the movers and the shakers, and the hidden gems from all over the Bay. Let us shine a spotlight on your business. Sponsorship opportunities are available. For more information, visit us at spotlightwithshonda.tv.
So they say it's a man's world? I don't see anybody's name on it.
While they were doing their thing, we slowly changed all.
Today, women can do anything men can do. And there's one thing we're even better at.
Stay linked in with us as you follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram. And remember, hashtag Spotlight with Shonda. We're going to take a journey through Oakland.
Okay.
And see some of that as well.
Yeah, right. when I drive down those streets.
Just to take us back down memory lane.
Oh, I'm like, oh, I could just taste it.
So we're leaving Mind Seed?
We're leaving Mind Seed.
Okay.
The Mind Seed compound.
Where it all happens. We just going to give them a little taste.
That's where
taste
it first became, because you know, that's Tasfaranga, and that's, I did my first talent show right there.
Wow.
Really. I lost too. You know, we lost.
You know what? The losers always do best.
Hey, man.
Everybody
a lot from losing.
That has a losing story is always a winner. So we rolling the sun rooftop, leaning and seeing.
Come on, with a gangsta link.
So we go to the second part of the Spotlight, Taste of Oakland. Riding through Oakland.
Yes.
Just to give everybody a taste of the history and what's all that we've evolved into from here.
Well, I guess this is still 85th. Still the same way, you know, but except for the towers that they used to have, the village has changed. But, you know, back then, growing up for us, a lot of talent shows, a lot of things that were in school that gave us the opportunity to learn how to, you know, do our craft, home in on our craft, like playing the guitar. You know,
right.
The music department was really like, they have Oakland School of the Arts now. That's what our music department was like.
So what do you feel, how do you feel now about being from Oakland though? You know,
like I'm very proud to see that. I mean, I welcome the newcomers and what they say is gentrification going on and it's just a different situation, 100%. There's a lot of people that are coming over here to,
get a taste of Oakland.
Let's just put it like that.
Oakland.
East Oakland Youth Development Center, boom.
Yeah, there we go. We gotta stop there. That's gotta be a And look at Regina doing just a great job.
Oh, man,
look at how this center is just taking over this whole corner and how beautiful that is and all the learning.
I just recently saw her and Marshawn Lynch.
In Haiti. Were you over there too?
I wasn't in Haiti.
Okay,
I was
you were
in
South Africa. Yes. Right, right.
Johannesburg is incredible.
Both of those places are life-changing to go visit.
Yes.
Haiti and South Africa. Let's just talk about South Africa. Now you've been since Mandela is passed. I haven't been since he passed.
Okay, yeah, this is my first time.
Okay.
That was my first time going to Africa. When I touched the ground over there, I don't know.
Oh, wow.
My eyes watered. I just feel like, wow.
It's like life-changing, right? You feel like you're home.
You feel it. You really feel like it's home. And then, you know, all the people there are just so warming, you know, and just like, you don't understand. We have been waiting for you.
Right.
We have to make that connection. That's one thing I said about my nonprofit that I really want to work on, giving kids from my community and other communities around this nation the opportunity to see Africa.
All right, so we're on 82nd Ave.
We are on 82nd now. I did a lot of damage on the street, I must say.
When I was a little girl, we lived on 82nd Ave. Oh, we were living on 81st. You know, Sly and the Family Stone, I feel like, fast forward, that's Tony for that generation. Sly and the Family Stone was for us.
Katie Kirk didn't even get it like this, girl.
Well, because we come over.
That's what I'm talking about.
Get a different, like, little...
Now, here we go.
This is
Castlemont.
Flashback.
We had a song called The Castellers, let me tell you. It was the reason why.
The Castellers
are
legends.
Mr. Rita, he was the man, the staple that really showed us a lot. We were blessed to have him in our lives.
Well, that's where the Tonys all...
Yes, that's how we got groomed. Yes.
Your old stomping ground. What's your funniest Castlemont story?
Oh, when I got...
That you can tell on camera.
The funniest one is the realest one. Me getting stuck in a tuba locker.
What's a tuba? A tuba with the instrument?
Yeah, the big tuba.
How'd you get stuck in it?
We were cutting class, and I snuck into the music wing. And this is when I first got up to Castlemont.
Uh-huh.
I wanted to hear the band play, so I hid in a tuba locker. And one of my buddies caught himself being funny, locked me in there. And I had to sit in that position the whole day.
No.
Yes, until roughly 3:30.
So how'd they find out you were in there?
Well, it got real quiet in the room and the whole bit, and I sat there, and then I just kicked the door open.
All right, so we're on 106. We're almost at the Dunsmere. We have done a tour of East Oakland, deep east.
So we are wrapping up. We are getting ready to pull up to the Dunsmere.
So we got our Tony jackets on. What is this Tony? What's the significance of this Tony jacket?
Well, this one right here happens to be a vintage piece of ours. You know what I mean? It was made by a gentleman called Squareware, who did all of the Tony stuff. You remember, we came out with the polka dots and all the crazy hats and whatever. All of our stuff
was doing. Because it's a hat to match it.
Yeah. And the tie.
Yeah.
And so.
Look how pretty it is. These are the days when you know why the Bay Area is such a fond place. It's so beautiful.
Gotta love it.